بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I'd like to start by mentioning this hadith of the Prophet عليه السلام. يأتي على الناس زمان القابض فيه على دينه كالقابض على الجمر. It means approaching you are days of patience during which the one who will be steadfast to his religion will be like the one holding on to a burning coal. And we are seeing how today, when we speak in matters pertaining to the basics of the belief, some people object, some people belittle that, and some seem to be hearing this information for the first time, despite this knowledge being among the fundamentals of the belief. Brothers and sisters in Islam, be cautious. Just because a person claims to be a sheikh, or is famous on social media and has many followers, does not mean that he is preaching the truth. By learning the knowledge of the religion, one will be able to distinguish between the man who is speaking what complies with the religion and between the liar who is leading people astray. The group of people called Al-Khawarij who were fought by some companions, even though from what appears to many, they seem to be praying a lot, fasting a lot, and reciting the Quran. Yet the Prophet ﷺ called them blasphemers, non-Muslims, because they deviated from the proper belief. And today, we have many of these people who are misguiding, leading people to hellfire. Imam Ali, the fourth righteous caliph, said, سيرجع قوم من هذه الأمة عند اقتراب الساعة كفارا. فقال رجل يا أمير المؤمنين كفرهم بماذا؟ أبالإحداث أم بالإنكار؟ فقال بل بالإنكار ينكرون خالقهم فيصفونه بالجسم والأعضاء. It means some people among this nation will turn out of Islam as the day of judgment draws closer. Someone asked him, what is their blasphemy due to? Imam Ali answered, they do not have the proper belief in their creator. They attribute to him having a body and body parts. And this, brothers and sisters in Islam, is being spread by some groups today. They exist today. They dress like a sheikh, they have beards, they preach in many mosques, but they were still referred to as blasphemers because they resemble God to his creation by attributing a body to him and body parts. The matter, brothers and sisters in Islam, is simple to understand. Be affirmed that God who created the skies, earth, and the throne Al-Arsh existed before creating the skies and earth and Al-Arsh without a place. And after creating them, God does not change. Hence, God exists without a place. The Quran teaches us that God does not resemble any of his creation. Allah Ta'ala said, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. The verse means nothing resembles Allah at all. And whatever is in a place has a volume. It means it is created. Volumes, shapes, sizes, bodies, all these are created. And for sure, God is not attributed with having a volume. So God exists without a place as he did before creating the earth, the skies, and Al-Arsh, the throne. And keep in mind that the verses of the Quran do not contradict each other. So be warned against those who liken God to his creation. The verse Ar-Rahmanu 'ala al-'arshi istawa means the throne is subjugated by Allah. However, this Mushabbiha group, this group that likens God to his creation, they falsely claim that the verse means that Allah sits on the throne. But they said, we do not know how the sitting is. And by that, they negated the verse, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. They went against this verse. The verse means nothing resembles Allah in any way. And sitting is a characteristic of the creation. Humans and animals sit. It is not befitting to be attributed to Allah. Now listen to how one of these misguided mushabbiha is belying the Quran by misinterpreting the verses and misguiding people by that.
That's three in one. The first question asked by her niece, that where is Allah? And she stumbled across the verse of Surah Sajda, Allah is on us, and that's correct. But the answer of yours is correct, that Allah is established on his throne. But Allah also says in Surah Shura, chapter number 42, verse number 11, Laysa laka mithlihi shay. There is nothing whatever like him. Allah hears and sees, but Allah does not hear and see like you and me, like our ears and our eyes. So you say, how is the arsh? You start thinking of a chair. How is Allah's arsh? Allah wala. So Quran says Allah is on arsh, that is the right answer. And his arsh extends throughout. We have a thinking, you know, arsh how. So whatever description is given in hadith, we accept it. We don't add to it. There are various hadith. There is a hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the lady came to the, her lady was there. And Prophet wanted to test her. Is she a mu'min or not? So the Prophet asked her. Well, she said on top. The Prophet said, she has iman. Wow. That is the reason when we do dua, we put our hand on the top. Correct? Yeah. So you can give the answer, Allah is on top, that's also correct. Allah is on arsh, that's also correct. Both.
You heard how he mentioned the verse, Laysa kamithlihi shay, but right away he went against it by attributing sitting to God. Brothers and sisters in Islam, nowhere in the Quran is it mentioned that God sits. Nowhere is the term yajlis referred to Allah in the Quran, because the verses of the Quran do not contradict each other. The Quran teaches laysa kamithlihi shay, hal ta'lamu lahu samiyya, wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. And the term stawa has 15 meanings in the Arabic language. Some of these 15 befit to be attributed to God, and some do not. And among their meaning is to subjugate and to conquer, which befit to be attributed to Allah. And among its meanings is to sit, which does not befit to be attributed to Allah. These mushabbiha left out the meanings that are befitting to be attributed to God, such as that the throne is subjugated by Allah, and instead they use the term sitting. Zakir Naik claimed that God sits, but he said we don't know how. Doesn't he know that whatever sits must have a body, upper part and a lower part? Doesn't he know that bodies are created? He claimed we don't know how. But doesn't he know that the question how is asked about created things? How is the form, or how is the shape, or how does it look? All these are used to describe creations, but the term how does not apply to the creator. Sitting, regardless of how it is an attribute of creations that have bodies. And then he claimed that God is in the sky, and he accused the Prophet of having said that, walayyadhu billah. The Prophet alayhi salam does not contradict the Quran. This hadith, referred to as Hadith al-Jariyah, the scholars disagreed about its authenticity due to the different narrations. And the ones that confirmed it, they said that the Prophet ﷺ asked her about her belief about the status of God. And she replied by saying fi as-sama', which literally means in the sky. And the scholars said she meant by that that God has a very high status. The term Ain in the Arabic language is used for places and for asking about the status. Some scholars said that the hadith is not true, and some said that the woman was mute, meaning she couldn't speak. And even the ones that said that she replied by saying fi as-sama', they said she meant that God has a high status. Know that we lift our hands when making dua, because the sky is the direction for dua, as the Kaaba is the direction for the prayer. God is not in the Kaaba and not in the sky. I will conclude by stating what the real trustworthy scholars said in this regard. Imam al-Shafi'i said, Al-Mujassimu Kafir. It means the one who attributes to Allah bodily characteristics blasphemes, meaning he's a kafir, a non-Muslim.